Women's basketball, who posted 18 wins last season, just the fourth most in program history, returns a number of key contributors this season. And of course, they'll look to build on the continued success of that program under third-year coach Tamara Inoue.
This team is really fun to watch, and I think you'll see a lot of players on different nights do some special things. So you can't just come out just one night to watch Andy play. I think on the next night you'll see Lauren do something. On the next night you'll see Yazzie do something. So the next day you'll see Sabrina. So I just don't think you just come out for one game to watch this particular player. I think you used to have a lot of players to watch. We've got a great, exciting team. I think everybody's playing together. You can highlight one player. You know, I think one player will be highlighted every game. I don't think we have one star, and that's the way I like to run my teams.
Coach Inoue very intentionally building that challenging non-conference schedule just so that when it does come time for Big West play, her team has faced all the systems that they need to in order to have success in conference play.
You know, we are challenging ourselves this year, and we're going to play Oregon, who I'm confident will be a Final Four team this year, and I think that's really good for our team. But those are type of games that I want to put us in situations to really see, to go up against the best. And I think that's exciting for our team, and they're excited for it, you know. But I think just every game that we go up against is strategically put in by myself, and I think that every game is going to be a battle in one way, shape, or another. You know, we're going to play a fast team, we're going to play a zone team, we're going to play, you know, a Princeton team. You know, every team that we're playing in preseason, we'll see in conference. And so that's kind of my idea of how I schedule in conference. Like I say all the time, it's anybody's ball game. You know, I think, Davis just runs a great system. You know, Northridge, you know, Santa Barbara, you just never know. It's always a good rival. Long Beach, always a great rival. You know, Hawaii, they do a great job. I mean, you can never have an off night. You know, Riverside, they'll hit you that motion day in, day out. So, I mean, I just think you have to really worry about whoever you play. You know, and Cal Poly, you know, Faith, we just always have good games. Always, no matter what. No matter if we're good or we're bad, we're always going to have good games. So I think those are things that we have to always worry about. There's not a bad team in this conference that we can just say, you know, sit back and relax today.
Despite the program making its first postseason appearance since 1995, the team is really now looking to leverage that experience that they gained last season and better equip themselves both physically and mentally to help sustain them through the 2018-19 season.
Probably the most viable tool we had last year was ending that way. And really, I think with our team, really we had 10 newcomers. 9 of them really hasn't played Division I before. You know, I think for them it's seeing how long a season actually is for basketball. You know, we are the longest season in the NCAA, and we go until March. I expect to go until March, you know. And so I think they were not realizing the toll it took on their bodies and the amount of commitment it takes to be ready every game. You can't just win one game and come in the next game and expect to win the next one. Like, you have to be ready. And I think that's a big key, I think, from last year. What we can really take away and learn from is every game is a new day. Anything can happen. Just because you beat them once doesn't mean you're gonna beat them again. And I think those are big valuable assets we're gonna take. I think the best thing as a coach last year, when I talked to my mentors and some friends, is that we're gonna be a year older. You know, my freshmen are now sophomores, and that makes a big difference. You know, my sophomores are now juniors, and you know, with that year under their belts, I think you see a big stride. You know, practices are going quicker. We're not teaching as much anymore. We're just getting better, and I think the no days off and the mentality of getting in the gym and making sure they're fine-tuning themselves is playing a big part to where we are so far.